My name is Tyson Bolts. I'm with Revere Health Weight Loss and Nutrition Center. I work in Orem, and we also have a group in Provo. We manage the adult pediatric patient, and today I'm here and we'll be talking about a little bit of what we have to offer to the pediatric patient and how hopefully maybe we can help you out. One thing I wanted to pass on is to let you know, this is really important to me. I've suffered with this my whole life. I had issues when I was in elementary school, when I was in junior high, when I was in high school. So I'm really excited to be able to try to help these individuals that maybe felt how I felt sometimes and be able to do stuff that I didn't have access to. And so our group, as I stated, takes care of the pediatric and adult patient. And so today we'll be a little bit more about the pediatric side. One thing that we want to do as a group is follow research and make sure that our group is following guidelines that will help and benefit individuals. And so that's what we've tried to set up for the pediatric patient, was guidelines to help guide our practices and to offer the best outcomes that we can. Also, not just research-based, we want to take a holistic approach. And what I mean by a holistic approach is including the family and including a provider, a dietitian, a health coach, a fitness specialist, and a behavioralist. And our group offers all of this. And I think it's really important to have this so we can really take care of the family and maybe your child. What we want a child to gain from this program by the time we get to the goal that they want to be is hopefully we've developed healthy habits that will last into adulthood, improve health and quality of life, and improve body composition, prevent future adverse health events. And what would this be? Hopefully prevent diabetes, prevent heart disease, decrease cholesterol issues if there's genetic issues in the family, and so just be able to give them better long-term management, and also improve body image and self-esteem. And how do we do this? So we've set up some stages to try to help guide the way we manage patients. But first, we need to figure out where a patient falls into. And so we follow a percentile. I know everyone's heard of the BMI. BMI is a 25 to is good, is healthy. Anything above 25 is overweight, and then greater than 30 is obese. But this is a little different for the pediatric patient. We follow a percentile. And so the percentile is set up as less than fifth percentile is underweight. Greater than fifth percentile to 84th percentile is sort of that healthy range that we want to see the pediatric patient in. Anything greater than 85 to 94 is overweight. If you're greater than that, then at higher risk for issues that we definitely want to try to take care of. And so that's what we base our assessment off of, is trying to figure out what percentile the child is in. Once we figured out what percentile, this gives us a staging. And so we have four stages. Our first stage is what we call the prevention plus stage. This would be a patient that would come in for just basically structured weight management. They're probably likely not overweight, or just maybe in that overweight category. This doesn't have to be a patient that's overweight. Maybe this is a patient that's malnourished. We still can help that individual out, and that's where we have the dietitian. This area, we probably would not use medications. I don't think we probably would need blood work. This would be maybe your child's in a certain sport, soccer, football, track, running, and you just want to have a better idea of what type of meals this patient should be on. And so this would be that prevention plus, coming in and reviewing that a little bit. The second approach is what we call structured weight management. And this would be that patient that is greater than the 85th percentile in between overweight and then obesity. This would be a monthly visit, meeting with our dietitian to establish an evaluation and a plan to get started. Sometimes maybe we'll consider blood work at this point. Sometimes it's not needed. It would be discussed with the parents and the patient and try to do the best thing that we could for your child. The third stage that we move into is what we call the comprehensive multidisciplinary intervention. This is where a patient, we need that holistic care. We need to involve the family. We need to make sure that we have the dietitian, the provider, the fitness specialist, behavioralist. This is where we would all meet together and start working on a plan that can sit up, that hopefully your child can follow. And once again, this is so important to have the family involved with this. These visits would probably be on a weekly visit, maybe every 2 weeks, depending on the person that we met with. The visits, we also, this is at the time we finally would focus on decreasing the calories. This will be either through dietary or exercise or a little bit of both. But we definitely have to decrease the calories and start assisting in weight loss at this point. Sometimes we consider medications. Medications, they're a tool to assist. They're not this magical pill that's going to just help someone lose all this weight. We really want to set it up as a tool to assist weight loss and have a patient grasp a better plan for long-term management than to rely on a medication. And so sometimes the medications are useful during this stage. It doesn't have to be an appetite suppressant. We have other medications. Sometimes maybe it's emotional. Maybe this is stress related. And so we've got to manage that area. There is medications that we can use for that. Maybe this is a glucose issue, pre-diabetes. And so we have a glucose intolerance. And so sometimes there's medications that we would use for that. So it's not always an appetite suppressant that has to be used to take care of a patient. Also at this stage, we probably want to look into doing some blood work. Definitely look for some genetic disorders. This would be like Fragile X syndrome, Prader-Willi's syndrome. There's a lot of things that could maybe be making your child gain weight that you're not aware of, thyroid issues. And so at this stage, this is the time that we would probably dive in and try to figure out what's going on and be a little bit more aggressive. Also, after this stage, we move into a stage called tertiary care intervention. This is our most aggressive stage. This is a patient that we've tried working with that holistic group, tried medication, and maybe we're just not moving in the direction that we all expect the patient should be going. And so this is a time where we might recommend meal replacement. Now, meal replacement's not for everybody. This is why we wait for this stage. And if we have to use meal replacement, we do offer Optifast in our group. It is medically researched and medically recommended, but we do use other things outside of our program. We want this program to be something that will help your family. And if you feel like there's something out there instead of Optifast that you would feel better for your child, then we're all for it. But we definitely at this stage probably would move over to meal replacement. And sometimes we also would need to consider maybe a surgical approach also. And we do have referrals that we refer people to. And so these are sort of the stages that we have and will place the child in and just the best care that we can offer and try to direct that care in the right direction. And that's why we have them, is to give us really good guidelines. And so, like I said, this is very, very short lecture today. This was just a little bit telling you about our program and how hopefully we can maybe help your child. And it's been great. I've been doing this now for about 4 years, is in weight loss management. I did family medicine for about 2 to 3 years prior to this. But this has been so great to work with kids. I know how they feel. I understand the hardships that, or the frustration that they can have and not have someone to talk to. And that's what I want you to realize, is we're here for your child. We're here to help them out. It's so great when I have kids come in and I'm able to see that they're losing weight. One patient that I've had has been great watching. He initially came in, it was 10 pounds, came back, it was 30 pounds. It was 40 pounds, 50, 60, 70. And it's such a great feeling to know that this can change their whole outcome in life. And so if you guys are interested in our program, we would love to have you. Like I said, we have an office in Orem and an office in Provo. And this is with Revere Health Weight Loss and Nutrition Center. And once again, my name's Tyson Bolts. I would love if you want to leave any type of questions, we'll get back to them and answer them the best we can. Once again, I appreciate those who have logged into at this time, and sure there'll be some other people that will log in later. But that's really all that I have today. And like I said, please leave your comments and then we will get back to them. And then I was just reading, Heather Johnson just left, has a comment. What about meal preparation for Crohn's disease in kids? So we definitely have a dietitian that works with Crohn's disease and probably can set up a meal plan with your child. And so would love to have him come in and discuss this a little bit with us. Also, we, as I stated prior in this video, we do use medications. It's not something that we go to right away. It's something that we want to just use as a tool. And so, like I said, but once again, leave your messages, and when I get time, I'll try to get back to them, and we'll go from there. So thank you for tuning in today, and I appreciate your time. Thank you.